بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد، كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم ألهمنا مراشد أمورنا وأعذنا من شرور أنفسنا. The chapter we are speaking about is Babur Riya wa Sum'ah, the chapter of show. Normally this word Riya goes together with the word Shirk. It is called Shirk-e Khafi, a very slight level of Shirk. So the hadith that is mentioned in the first, third chapter of this Bab of Faslu Thalis, which is narrated in the kitab called Shu'abul Iman, a very nice narration. The wording is very unique. It starts off that Umar radiallahu anhu once came to the masjid of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he finds Sayyiduna Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu anhu crying. So he asks Hazrat Mu'adh radiallahu anhu that what has made you cry. So he says, it's a sentence that I had heard from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and when I think about it, it brings tears to me. So obviously when we hear about it, it must also have a similar effect. The narration will explain the difference between wanting to be known, which everyone normally wants, and being hidden, which normally no one wants. A man always wants to know that I'm known. So the narration speaks about the two opposites. The man who's known, that he is going to be known as a mushrik, as a man who did everything for show. And one man is unknown, but from him Almighty Allah spreads a lot of light in the world. Why it makes a person cry is because this world is such that normally as soon as a person starts doing a little work, Allah Tabarak Ta'ala makes it that he becomes known. The unique thing of this narration is, as long as man gets sad, and always he keeps it in the front of his mind, previously when we did the chapter of ghina, wealth, and the honor of faqr, we explained that the desire is not that everyone must hate wealth, because we will not hate wealth. But at least so much is we must understand, loving wealth is never a maqsad. Poverty was an honor. Similarly here, the desire to be not known, which you'll never hear about. The desire to be not known is a great thing. And being known is not the best of things. So you will become known, we all will become known. But being known is not the best. Not being known is the easiest. You save from a lot of problems. And not being known never means that you will never be accepted for deen. This narration and many others show that those people who Allah accepts them for a lot of work in the world, they are unknown. You'll wonder, how can you be unknown? So remember, light is something that is not noticed, but it's seen by everyone. Light is not noticed. For example, the light is on. No one will ever say, what a light. That light goes off, then you see darkness. That is light. There were those people in the country, in the world, while they were alive, the whole town was safe from problems. The day they passed away, the problems came. So light spread. But the people came and made salam to them, hugged them, honored them, gave them hadiya. They were that cause of goodness for everyone. So if a person's desire is only to be accepted for deen, then it doesn't mean being known. And if a person's desire is to be known, then being hidden will never go with him. Mu'adh radiallahu anhu cried when he says, I would think of this wording. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spoke about three different parts in this narration. The first part is what is called the opposite of not being. The opposite of not being, of being hidden, the opposite is being known. But being known normally goes together with shirk, that I want to be noticed. So the hadith starts that Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna yaseera riya'i shirkun. That even a small amount of show, that is also called shirk. Inna yaseera riya'i shirkun. One is riya, to show. One is a man says, there's only little poison. It won't harm you. In the chapter of Riya, it was said, even little is lot. Even a little is lot. Inna yaseera riya ishirkun. Mullah Ali Qari rahimullah got a unique manner that he used to rhyme a lot of wording. So here also he hit one rhyme. He said, this yaseeru riya. He said, riya, why you call it even a little of riya? He said, that little riya, he said, it's kadabi bin namlati sauda. He said, it is so, that you can't pick it up. It is so delicate. It goes so unnoticed. It is like that sound of that annamlati sauda. So he says, kadabi bin namlati sauda. Like the walking of the black ant. Ala sakhrati samma. And he's walking on that rock. And that rock is like bare, that is not going to make any sound of some sand moving, some stone moving. Fil laylati zalma. This is a dark night. So that part was the nice rhyme. But then he ends with a little bit scary part. He says, Qallama yaslamu minhul aqwiya. Qallama yaslamu minhul aqwiya. Fakayfa bidduafa. He says, Kadabi bin namlati sauda. Ala sakhrati samma. Fil laylati zalma. Like the tiptoe or the movement of that black ant on that rock on a dark night. But the scary part was قَلَّمَا يَسْلَمُ مِنْهُ الْأَقْوِيَا, which very little the strong of mankind has ever saved themselves from. فَكَيْفَ بِالْدُعَفَا. He says, then what to speak of the weak of mankind? That little riya is going to come. إِنَّ يَسِيرَ الرِّيَا يِشِرْكُن. That is why when we make tawbah, one of the unique tawbahs was اللَّهُمَّ إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ أَنْ أُشْرِكَ بِكَ شَيْئًا وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ وَأَسْتَغْفِرُكَ لِمَا لَا أَعْلَمُ. Hazrat Hakim Muhammad Akhtar Sahib Rahimullah would prescribe this thing. When he would teach, they would ask, what is the hila? This also is mentioned in the hadith, a very similar wording. But it easily, because that slight change in wording doesn't harm anything much. So he read your first kalima. إِنِّي أَعُوذُ بِكَ مِنْ أَنْ أُشْرِكَ بِكَ شَيْئًا وَأَنَا أَعْلَمُ. I ask your protection from shirk. Had we only been taught shirk is the big shirk, me and you would never have asked, oh Allah, protect me from shirk. Because shirk for me and you meant I won't worship the idol. So I'm not a mushrik. This narration was going to show there's going to be shirk that enters into everyone. Then the person will say, oh Allah, I ask your protection from shirk. And the shirk that is already in me, I ask your forgiveness for that. Please, so much we can do. Inna yaseera riya'i shirkun. So remember, every time you get noticed, there's going to be that shirk. Every time we get noticed, there will definitely be. Yes, Lord shirk there won't be. But yaseera riya'i is going to be there. So the desire to be noticed in the world is not the best of desires. Because when it comes with its shirk. The second part of the narration, and you'll wonder, like, what's the relationship between the two? Allah Tabarakala, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam then said, وَمَنْ عَادَ لِلَّهِ وَلِيًّا فَقَدْ بَارَزَ اللَّهِ بِالْمُحَارَبَةِ. Like how you all did another narration, مَنْ عَادَ لِي وَلِيًّا فَقَدْ آذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. مَنْ عَادَ لِلَّهِ وَلِيًّا. That person who gets hatred for any friend of Almighty Allah. من عادى لله وليا فقد بارز الله بالمحاربة. Then he must understand that he has stood up to make war with Allah himself. Under it, they write this. They said, you have seen a lion and the cub of the lion. They said, at certain times it's easier to fight with the lion instead of the cub. Because when the cub is attacked, the lion goes wild. There are certain selected servants of Almighty Allah. The problem is, it's not known who they are. Had it been known very nicely, he's a wali, there was a sign on top of his head, wali, everyone will stay away. Don't touch the wali. Almighty Allah did a unique thing. Because al-khalqu iyalullah. The whole world was going to be like the household of Almighty Allah. Ahabbul khalqi ilallah man ahsana ila iyali. The most beloved to Allah was then going to be told the one who's looking after the family of Allah, meaning kind. Opposite is when you don't like the world. You got enmity with everyone. You hate everyone. So hating everyone is one. Almighty Allah hid who is His selected servants. Remember the first part of the narration, to be known, that was called you like a mushrik. So the wali is not going to be known. Normally when we say he's a great wali of Allah, that's, we have husn azan, we say, Hazrat, make dua for me. So definitely many a time, according to our husn azan, he is the wali. From him we will take benefit. But many a time, the one who is known, he will have yaseer al-riya'i, a little of riya. So there's going to be that wali who's unknown, which the narration will now explain. The unknown person could definitely be the wali of Allah. And if he is the wali of Allah and you hated him, you caused him difficulty. فَقَدْ بَارَزَ اللَّهُ بِالْمُحَارَبَةِ And you have actually told, oh Allah, let's do war. Then that person now gets worried. Every person in front of him he sees as a potential wali. Every person in front. He could be the friend of Allah. That person no longer will be ready to mock at someone. Because in case he's the wali of Allah. You don't interfere with the lion cub when you know the lion is around. But even if you don't know the lion is around, but you're not sure, even then you say leave it. Because what if that elephant just pitches up and the baby elephant is in front? What if that elephant? In every man you will see, there'll be that fear, what if he is the selected servant of Allah? If ever you mock someone, then at night you'll worry about it. That have I waged a war today with Allah? Because when Almighty Allah shoots, then you don't see the bullet, but it hits. A lot of things in life start going wrong, starts going upside down. The rich man sees everything collapsing. The man who was so good just sees it falling to the ground. You don't know from where and where the slaps are coming. But perhaps it was that you hit the wrong target. So that man will now become very worried. Must I mock someone? Because it could be a good person you mocked, it could be a weak person you mocked. It could be someone who's known as pious reading tahajjud. It could be someone who's not known. The next part of the narration will show you that who could be the wali of Allah. So Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam now speaks about who is this wali. He says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْأَبْرَارَ الْأَتْقِيَاءَ الْأَخْفِيَاءَ Remember, Almighty Allah has a lot of love for al-abrar. Those very selected servants of Allah. But who are they? Al-atqiya, they stay away from sin. Al-akhfiya, they are hidden from all. Now we don't know them. Al-ladhina idha ghabu lam yuftaqadu. If they're not in the majlis, no one will even miss them. Wa in hadaru lam yud'au wa lam yuqarrabu. And even if they're in the majlis, no one says, Hazrat, come front, you make dua. They just, normal. They just sit. They themselves don't even know they're so close to Allah. They themselves don't know. They're that normal person. That simple guy that you make a salam to him and salam. قُلُوبُهُمْ مَصَابِيحُ الْهُدَىٰ It is their hearts that are the lights of hidayat for the world. قُلُوبُهُمْ مَصَابِيحُ الْهُدَىٰ يَخْرُجُونَ مِنْ كُلِّ غَبْرَاءَ مُظْلِمَةَ This غَبْرَاءَ مُظْلِمَةَ got two meanings. غَبْرَاء means like dusty. مُظْلِمَةَ means dark. Allama Tibi translates it that their dwellings, their houses are such and so simple that it's like dirty in their houses, dusty. That was in the past. There's hardly any lights. They haven't got that candle. You go inside, it's like an old house. So it means he lives a life of poverty. That's possible, one meaning. And they come from very simple dwellings also. There's no shan, there's no show about them. Second meaning is, يَخْرُجُونَ مِنْ كُلِّ غَبْرَاءَ مُظْلِمَةَ غَبْرَاءَ مُظْلِمَةَ means anything dark. Anything dark means بَلِيَّةٌ مُعْضِلَةٌ When a major problem falls, when calamity came, when great fitna came, but they are so unique people, Almighty Allah makes them, they just slip out of the calamity. It doesn't hit them. The fitna doesn't grab them. They don't get caught into the problem. Because they're like so close to Almighty Allah, He just pulls them out. They just slide out. يخرجون من كل غبراء مظلمة. Fitna does not grab them. But who they are, they're so hidden that I won't know them, you don't know them, perhaps they don't know themselves. That your one dua is the dua shaking everything. Because we don't know who they are. Now everyone around us got the potential to be that one. It could be your wife next to you. It could be your son. For the son it could be my father and mother. For you people it could be the Nazim who you don't like. It could be. The word could be means it could be anyone. Now a person that inner feelings of anger, hatred, jealousy, it could be that other boy in your class that you just say he can't be the wali. He's just a show off, but he could be. Because the one who you least expect could be the one. So that's من عادى لله وليا فقد بارز الله بالمحاربة. Everyone you will look at, you will just worry. Must I make a war with Allah? And then one thing you will realize, that what creates this enmity for the people around us? Why do I become angry with someone who hasn't done anything to me? It's just, I don't like him. He's a show-off. What is making me say he's a show-off? So that first part of the narration. Inna yasira riya'i shirkun. That remember a little riya is shirk. But what it meant is when you want to be noticed, it will hurt you if anyone else is getting noticed. When you want to be noticed, it will hurt you if anyone else is getting noticed. If you find you're getting enmity and hatred, jealousy for people around, then immediately you must worry about, am I the mushrik? Am I the mushrik? Many a person then does come and says, there are some people I just can't see. So then the answer is, alhamdulillah, once you picked it up, then you got no problem. Because shaitan will continue troubling you. He will make you hate the person further. So that blow of shaitan, you can't get it out. You will have to actually go up to the person and give him a hadiah. While you're giving him the hadiah, you're wishing he dies tomorrow. You will have to do it. Why? Because the walk towards him is in your control. Your heart is not in your control. A man has to show Almighty Allah, I am not happy with what's within me. So your tongue is in your control, so you can make a dua for him. And although it's burning you so much that I don't like him at all, must I still make dua to him to get better? But the thing is, yes, you will make dua. The barakah of the dua, one is you have shown Almighty Allah that although I dislike some servant of yours, but it's in me. I don't have control of what's in. But my tongue is in my control. The second is once you start making dua for people you don't like, an angel will make dua for you also. So when you got the dua of the angel, your own dua you know is normally not going to be accepted. So you don't be accepted. An angel dua will be accepted. When you will start doing this, your heart will start opening. Many people say, what is the sharh sadr? Sharh sadr is the opposite of dhiq sadr. Dhiq sadr is when you got a chest that is so small and tight that you got no place for anyone in it. You hate everyone. Why? Because you only got your place in it. You got no place to expand. Let him also come. A man becomes so tight, that he thinks the treasures of Almighty Allah are also so tight. So if you see somebody else going far in life, he's becoming famous, it hurts you. As though in the treasures of Allah there's only place for one person. It's either him going to win or you going to win. When this heart starts becoming bigger, you start becoming more forgiving, more loving, more smiling. When you will do that, you will smile more. Your inside will start smiling. You will like to be less noticed because now you're going the opposite. Allah Tabarakallah will start making you His selected. From your heart, light will start spreading everywhere. When you will sit in a gathering, that shock and desire to be in front won't be so much then. You will be so happy to be unknown. And every time you called in front, then like Muaz radiallahu anhu cried, you will also be worried. That it should not be that as soon as I get called, I am out of that group. That al-abrar, the beloveds of Allah, al-atqiya, al-akhfiya, that when they're there, no one notices them. When they're not there, no one bothers. Suddenly you noticed, as soon as you come front, there will be no sun'at, there will be no show, that you'll have to come and sit in front and you'll say, me, you know, I'm the worst of all you people to speak here, but because I was called, you were waiting to be called. It won't be like that. You'll really think about this narration. And you say, I can sit here, perhaps this 5 minutes will make me back as a mushrik again. That person will think then. At night he will say, oh Allah, I seek your protection from shirk. And the shirk that is in me, I seek your forgiveness for it. Now he'll read that kalima with real. Man aada lillahi waliyan. He won't hate people around him. Everyone he will look at, he will say, perhaps he's the wali. The present moment in the world amongst ulama, there's so much of hatred, so much of fighting. For one alim to correct the error of another, if he feels it's an error, it's 100% his duty. But normally when it happens, which Imam Ghazali rahimullah, who when he entered the world of suluk, tasawuf, then his hand went onto the pulse. That's when he wrote, munazara is like haram. Munazara means debating. What made munazara haram? Munazara wasn't haram. But he put the hand on the pulse that whenever a debate takes place, that nafsi comes into it. It got to do with me. Not that haq must come out. I must come out right. So now in everything I will burn if I see him doing anything right. I will only look for his problems. What we must was man aada lillahi waliyan. That what if he is Allah's wali? And forget fighting with him, you have made a war with Allah. Will you manage this war? فَقَدْ بَارَزَ اللَّهُ بِالْمُحَارَبَةِ. Three things me and you have to worry about. One is, that every time we get noticed, am I a mushrik? Number two, every time I have enmity and hatred for someone, am I ready to make war with Allah? And number three, when I'm not being noticed, does it hurt me or does it make me happy? Not being noticed must be like my kamal. That's the maqsad. And then man will get noticed. The desire to be noticed, then you're spoiling the whole thing. Have that hope and love of faqr. Allah will give you wealth. No one waits, desires faqr and becomes poor. But when faqr is the main thing, then when wealth comes also, you don't get thrilled with it. You always say, I'm weak. Faqr is the real thing, poverty. And when the world, when you will be noticed, then an alim will be noticed. Especially in the world we're going through, of technology, even if no one saw you, you will make them see you. Because in every phone your message can come. They can't run away from it now. It'll come here, it will come there. You might even send your own bayan and you will write there, what a bayan. Somebody heard it. Whatever you want to, if you want to make yourself becoming in that world, you can't be not noticed. A man who yesterday no one noticed him, he got 10,000 followers. Because the world is like now. No one has to come from far and wide to come to you. You can go to everyone. But when the thing in the front is, the maqsad is to be unknown, then a time will come where you will become known. And you'll have to make yourself known. But always you understand, this was never the main thing. This is like I'm a ma'zoor. Like I'm the weak person. Three things. One is, when you see yourself being known, worry, am I a mushrik? Number two, when you see enmity and hatred coming in you, then think about it, am I ready to make war with Allah? And number three, when you're in a gathering, and that feeling comes, I wish I can be front, think of this. That Allah loves those servants who are hidden. From them so much of light is going to spread in the world. And they will come out of every fitna. يَخْرُجُونَ مِنْ كُلِّ غَبَرَاءَ مُظْلِمًا. If you will think about it, perhaps Allah will make me and you, like Mu'az bin Jabal radiallahu anhu, sometimes you will just sit alone and 1-2 tears will come out also. What I was supposed to be getting and where I landed up. The person who goes through this, he will read this kalima nicely. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من أن أشرك بك شيئا وأنا أعلم وأستغفرك لما لا أعلم. Until the ending. But even till day, which comes in one narration. So much, and Allah Ta'ala will save this person from this called this hidden shirk, which man cannot pick up himself. Almighty Allah will just make it maaf. Allah tabarak ta'ala bless us all with ikhlas. Ikhlas is a very unique thing. It makes everything happen. Allah pak save us all from riya, from show, from shirk. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah.